Hey you guys, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I figured I would share with you guys my Sephora recommendation. You guys know the sale is actually coming up this weekend, which I'm super excited about. I have already shared with you guys my wish list, so I kind of figured I would share with you guys some products that I think you should try out that you may actually like. So I do have a mixture of like eyeshadow palettes, foundations, highlighters, all that good stuff. So if you want to see my recommendations, then of course just keep watching. So when it comes to the sale, I kind of feel like you should splurge on things that you always have like your eyes on, whether it's like skincare, makeup, just anything your heart desires, because you do get that extra percentage off. For me, I like to get eyeshadow palettes because I kind of feel like you have to go a little bit high end for your eyeshadow palettes compared to like your foundations or like lip products. So I do have quite a few eyeshadow palettes in front of me. Starting off, I do have the Anastasia Beverly Hills Soft Glam Eyeshadow Palette. I did feature this product in a review already on my channel. I have it in my description box for you guys to check out. This palette is such a pretty eyeshadow palette. It's more of like your neutral eyeshadow palettes. You have like your neutral colors in the hair, your nice pretty like golds, your bronze colors, just a well-rounded everyday eyeshadow palette. It's definitely user-friendly because the shadows in hair aren't anything that's going to like be intimidating, and I do think you can create a nice soft glam look, or you can do like a nice like neutral eye look. It's up to you, but I do think it's a really pretty eyeshadow palette. You guys know her eyeshadows are really good quality eyeshadows. Pigmentation is amazing. They blend out really nicely, and you do get a little bit of fallout, but not too much fallout, and it's a nice price as well. Typically range like in a $40 price range, so it's not too expensive to where it's gonna break the bank. So I definitely think it's a product that you should try out. I will swatch two shadows for you guys so you can see what it looks like. You guys, these are so creamy to the touch. And here is the eyeshadows on my hand. So again, really pretty, really pigmented, nice quality eyeshadows. And I do think compared to like the Modern Renaissance, I know that's the one that everybody loves, but I kind of feel like when picking out my products, I try to pick products that was more like practical for everyday wear, because you're not gonna spend $60 for an eyeshadow palette that you won't wear every day. So I kind of feel like just pick products that they can wear on a day-to-day basis, because let's be realistic, we're living in a day-to-day versus the Instagram reality world. So everything in here is pretty much like your day-to-day that you can wear, you know, consistently. So that's why I picked out this product compared to the Modern Renaissance. Not saying you can't wear that one every day, but I just think this one is more everyday to me because of the color scheme and the eyeshadow palette. So love, love, love this one. Moving on to my next recommendation is going to be the Sephora Pro Eyeshadow Palette. This is the warm eyeshadow palette. I didn't get the other two because the warm pretty much spoke to me. And this is quite expensive, to be honest, but it's a really good quality eyeshadow palette. They pretty much killed it with this eyeshadow palette. It reminds me of the Natasha Denona Sunset eyeshadow palette. Here is the layout of the palette. As you can see, it's more of a warm tone. And if you don't know, because you're new to my channel, I am a warm tone girl when it comes to eyeshadows. It's just my personal preference. I just think it's more easy to work with, and it's more like on a neutral side and more like wearable in my opinion. So again, it's a nice quality eyeshadow palette. You do get a lot of kickback in this eyeshadow palette. Keep that in mind. However, the pigmentation is really good. It blends out really nicely. You can create so many looks with this eyeshadow palette. It is quite expensive, but you definitely get your money's worth with this eyeshadow palette, so keep that in mind. The mattes blend out really nicely, and the shimmer is really pretty as well. You don't have to spray your brush to get the pigmentation from the shimmer shades because they're already pigmented on their own. But if you want to, you can always spray the brush to intensify the eyeshadow look. Here is the swatches. I did one matte and one shimmer for you. So again, really pretty eyeshadow palette. Sephora definitely knocked it out of the park with that palette because it's amazing. Moving on to my next one is going to be by Tarte. It's the Tartlet Toasted Eyeshadow Palette. This is actually my first eyeshadow palette from them in terms of the whole like Tartlet series. Here is what it looks like. This palette is so pretty. I think it spoke to me because it's more on the warm side, but I just think it's a really good like neutral everyday eyeshadow palette. Again, pigmentation is really nice. Here is what a few colors look like swatch, and they are so amazing. Like, when I say the intensity is beyond out this world, like, amazing. Here is the two swatch right there. You don't get that many shimmer shades in this palette compared to your mattes, but the shimmer shades that you do get in here, they're really intense. And again, you can create so many looks with this eyeshadow palette. But I do think you guys will like this eyeshadow palette. Again, it's really pretty, really compact. So you can definitely travel with it. It's more so travel friendly. Packaging is so stinking cute. And I think it's a really good eyeshadow palette. So I think you guys should definitely check it out. Moving on, I do have from Too Faced is their Just Peachy Matte Eyeshadow Palette. And you're probably thinking, girl, like, this is an all matte eyeshadow palette. But you guys, when I say these mattes in here are so pretty, they're definitely your everyday kind of colors, so like your transition colors. And you guys know you always have that one eyeshadow palette where the transition colors in there suck because they're not pigmented, they don't match your skin tone, they're too gray, they don't show up, just all these different things. So I do think it's good to have a palette like this in your collection. And first of all, it smells amazing. It smells just like freaking peaches. It smells so sweet and so good. But when I say the color payoff is amazing, this color right here called Peach Sangria, if you pop that all over your lid, it is so pretty on its own. It's a really good eyeshadow palette. I just love every single color in here. I don't have like one particular favorite because they're all really good. So definitely check it out. None of the drugstores do have like matte eyeshadow palettes, i.e. like Milani. I know e.l.f. have one, but I think in terms of like a high-end option, this is definitely the way to go. And the colors in here aren't the typical like browns or blacks. It's like some really pretty warm colors, like your oranges, your burgundies, like your peachy colors. So it's a really nice palette, and the packaging is really cute. Like, come on now. All right, and then my last eyeshadow palette is going to be by Kat Von D. It's the shade Light eyeshadow palette. Now, this is what like a neutral matte eyeshadow palette look like. I do have this all over my eyes today for my eyeshadow look, but again, it's a really good palette to have in terms of like an all matte eyeshadow palette. Like I was telling you guys, the one from Too Faced, they have the more prettier like oranges, burgundies, and peaches like colors in there, whereas this one has more of like an actual like straight up browns, grays, blacks, whites in here. So you do have more of an actual neutral eyeshadow palette compared to this one where you have more fun colors to play with. So again, I don't think you need to have both. If I had to say just choose one, I would probably choose the one from Too Faced because you have some more prettier colors I had to play with compared to this one. But I do like this palette, so I definitely had to buy it. And I did buy this one first before the Too Faced one. So do like this palette. I don't reach for it as much anymore, but I do think it's a really pretty palette to have in your collection as well. Moving on to highlighters, I only have one because you guys, the drugstore have been killing the highlighter game lately, so I don't feel the need to spend a lot of money for a highlighter palette in Sephora compared to like the drugstore. So I do have one in front of me. It's by Bobbi Brown. It's called Bronze Glow. Here's what it looks like. This freaking highlighter is so pretty against my skin tone. I think if you are a woman of color, you should definitely have this in your collection because it looks really good against our skin tones. Like, it's just a really pretty highlighter color. Here is what it looks like. Pigmentation is amazing. It looks so pretty against the skin. They almost look like wet. So I do think you should definitely consider getting it. I know Fenty has some really good ones out there, but to be honest, if I had to choose this over Rihanna's, I would probably choose Bobbi Brown over hers because I just think it's a really pretty color. And again, it looks really good against our skin tone and the pigmentation is definitely intense. So do love this one a lot and definitely check it out. It's a really good one. All right, in terms of foundations, I only have two foundations here with me. Surprisingly, they're actually like both matte foundations, which is almost like, what? Because I do have dry skin, but I told you guys, in so many videos, good primer, good moisturizer, and I'm pretty much good to go. So I do have the Kat Von D and I also have the Fenty. Kat Von D is definitely more full coverage and I do love a full coverage foundation. I kind of feel like either go big or go home. So I do love her foundation. To some people, it might be too heavy or too full coverage, but to me, I don't mind. So definitely check it out if you like a full beat, like full coverage foundation. You will not be disappointed in her product at all. Rihanna's Fenty is more medium to full coverage. You have to build up the coverage to get it to be full, but it's more so medium to full. I do like it on the skin. It looks so pretty, so flawless, and she has so many shade range for everybody. So you can definitely find your color in her collection. So definitely check it out. And these two are my two like go-tos in my collection right now. I don't mind a medium coverage foundation. I just prefer a full coverage, but I just think because you can build up hers as well, like hers a lot. So love it. And then I do have like two random products. The first one is by Anastasia. It's the A23 brush. It's her highlighter brush. I always use this for all my highlighter applications on my face because it's an amazing shape. It's not too big, not too small. You can find it on her gondola at Sephora, or just purchase it online or on the website in her little like section on the website. But really good brush to have to highlight with, and it's amazing. Next product, it's the Sephora Color Switch by Vera Mona. I use this to clean my brushes all the time in between like my eyeshadow applications. I don't feel like washing my brush. This definitely comes in handy. You can also like switch it out and just use the other side. You can also like clean this so you can reuse it. That way you're not like using it and throwing it away. You can actually wash it when you're done with it. So if you want to like have something to clean your brushes in between applications, definitely get this. It's super inexpensive, you guys. You can find it in the Sephora collection. And it's definitely a good thing to have in your collection. Therefore, you're not washing your brushes all the time. You know. And then my last product is one lip product. You're probably thinking like, girl, one lip product. But again, I just kind of feel like lip products, I don't feel the need to spend that much money for a lip product where I can go to the drugstore and get it cheaper. But I do have the Rihanna Fenty Gloss Balm because I think it's a really pretty color. I have it on my lips today with some other colors as well, but it's a really good like universal color. You guys know I love a glossy lip, and I do love the flex of like shimmer in there. It's not a lot, just like some little flexes in there, and it's a really pretty glossy color, and it's so pretty on the lips. This will be a really cute like summer color, like for real. So definitely check this one out. But yeah, you guys, that's pretty much my Sephora recommendations. Hope you guys enjoyed my video. I don't have any skincare products because I typically do drugstore for like skincare products. However, I do have a few like high-end as well in my collection, but not enough to like recommend. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. Again, make sure you guys check out my description box for the dates of the sale and all that good stuff, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye guys.